Welcome to Dhanu on Fire right here on Hi TV, your luxury channel. This week, I'm at the Kingsbury Hotel and we're going to be dining at C'est La Vie, located right at their rooftop. With me, I have one of Colombo's favorite boys, Ranchan. It's Dhanu on Fire Season 3, powered by LICC. Thank you so much for joining us. With me, I have a fashion icon of Colombo, Ranchan, who loves food, who has had some heavy nights in the last few days. We're just recovering off Christmas, on Christmas.
Yes.
It's one of those. Tell me, how have you been?
I've been fantastic. Just, you know, the season's always busy and so many events going back and forth, but it's always nice to see familiar faces as well as people you haven't seen in a long time, and always good to catch up.
Now, we have gone through enough and more things in the country, and you as someone who is an entrepreneur of your own and also who has to think of your own wallet, whereas you cannot depend on an organization to back you up.
Sure.
How do you see our country evolving for the brand new year 2019?
Well, we can only hope that everything gets sorted out. And
that's in capital.
Yes, oh, yeah. Pretty much, right?
With sparkles and flowers popping all
exactly. over. Exactly. Yeah. But you know, we gotta just do our part and make sure that we are contributing to the success of the country and branding ourselves to the world as a destination that people want to go to and visit all the time. So we just have to do our part, really.
Yeah. Talking about branding ourselves to the world, we are at C'est La Vie. That's, of course, located at the Kingsbury Hotel. Come all the way to the top and you will find this spectacular place. It's actually one of Ranchan's favorite spots.
Yes, it is.
He actually knows the menu by heart, which is a bit annoying because I'm trying to say these Japanese words and I can't even say it. So I've decided to just order the main because I was able to read that. The rest, I've told the chef to just decide what he likes and feed me some food. Simple as that. Just do drop by the Kingsbury Hotel. This is phenomenal. It's a great spot. Everyone in Colombo is talking about it. And for a perfect photograph, you need to come when the sun is setting.
Absolutely.
Yeah,
absolutely.
It has everything that's going. So tell me about your food habits. Are you a big foodie?
I'm a massive foodie, yes.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
What's your go-to food at any given time?
Any given time, I would have to be Sri Lankan kiribat. Okay. To be specific.
But you sleep right after that.
Not really. I mean, really? I usually do like 8 to 10 piece and I'm fine.
What?
Yeah.
I think there's some drug in kiribat for me. The minute I eat it, I'm
really?
Huh. I'm just in a starry eye surprise.
Yeah, that's the food I would choose anything over anything else. But
okay.
I mean, food in general is my go-to and I just love trying new things. The only thing I don't eat is raw onions. I'll eat them cooked and sauteed and whatnot, but I'm just good
come
with
on,
anything.
The afterbreath is so beautiful.
I know, right?
Yeah, why would you ever let that go?
Well, I think past experience in my fraternity probably will shed some light on that specific event. Yeah.
All right. So tell me a little bit about, okay, mine is just an orange juice. I'm sorry. I just came out of kindergarten today. But what are you having?
Actually, that's roses a great question. Yeah. Looks like a
at this hotel, from
twist
the,
to a lime
from
juice.
The entrance all the way to the drink that a rose petals throw. You might just
it
end
is
up
a
with
twist to a lime juice with some soda in
twist
there.
Twist being the capital word there.
So
tell me about your cheat meals. What are your meal cheating qualities?
Cheat meals definitely has to be pizza.
What's your favorite pizza? Please don't tell me margarita and make me sad.
No. Pepperoni is my go-to, but I do love the mutton keema pizza from Harpo's.
Okay.
Any
That's
day.
Always something.
Any day, exactly.
Right. We've got the menu.
Awesome.
I'm going to let you pick first.
Sure.
Because you're the guest, no?
All right. Thank you.
Yeah, man, I can't read it anyway, so it's okay.
Where is that one? I'm going to go with this perfect starter right here, the bulgogi bao.
Sure.
Huh? The bun. Amazing. Can you say that, Dan?
I know. Bulgogi bao.
There you go.
Got it. Bulgogi
bao. Good job.
It's my new word I've learned for the day.
And I'm going to do the braised pork belly for main.
Sure.
And for dessert, how about mango cheesecake?
I've been told I'm sharing the dessert, just
Thank
to
you
give
so
you a
much.
Side note.
One bulgogi bao.
Yes.
One braised pork belly.
Yes.
One mango cheesecake.
Correct. Thank you so much.
Hello,
thank you.
I'm
and how about
here.
This guy?
I'm just chopped liver, I tell you, little by little.
One
just
more, one
I
more.
Know. I'm just throwing out. Okay, I'll just tell you the main I want, which I've memorized by heart. Hold on. Teriyaki chicken? Teriyaki chicken with garlic rice?
Yes. Fabulous.
The rest, it's up to you.
Thank you so much.
Thanks. That is if you bring some food for me. All right. So now that we know, you are married to someone who is not Sri Lankan.
Correct.
Now that we know he's married. tell me, how is it to sort of counteract food between her part of the life and yours?
Sure. Well, it's been a little challenging, especially because she doesn't eat spicy food.
Oh, yeah.
She doesn't eat seafood.
Yeah. For her, spice must be like very mild in our...
Oh, yeah. I mean, even the slightest bit of pepper sometimes is...
Oh.
Yeah, so I'd have to taste everything and kind of see, okay, may this be a little
but
too...
But I like smoke coming out of my ear.
Yeah.
We, so it's been tough. We have a dead tongue, right?
Right, exactly. Yeah. But we found some interesting restaurants that she kind of grew accustomed to and a few items on the menus that she can have.
Right.
So it's been easier.
Has she ever tried the whole rice and curry in the
oh,
real
yeah,
way?
Oh, yeah, for sure. She definitely has. And I think there's only been one instance where she's had more than one plate.
Oh, okay.
And that was at a home-cooked meal at my aunt's house.
Okay.
And it was just weird because she just kept going and going. I was like, what's wrong with you?
Was she turning pink?
No. Purple? She was good. She was not having any of the meats, just the veggies.
Which we can handle.
Exactly.
All right. Okay, so we have to speak about, now that we spoke about the food element, we'll speak about what sort of keeps his work life, health life, and all of these sort of balance when we do come back right here on Dhanu on Fire. Do stick around, it's Hi TV, and we are at Selavi at the Kingsbury Hotel. Welcome back to the show. It's Dhanu on Fire, powered by LICC. Thank you so very much for joining us on the show. It's Hi TV, your luxury channel. I'm dining here with Ranshan at Selavi. This is one fabulous restaurant. If you didn't know, when you come up onto the rooftop here at the Kingsbury, you have to just take a bit of a right turn and you'll find the restaurant. If you have not discovered it still, thank you. He went away.
Left.
I'm a bit directional-wise, a bit challenged. Anyway, just turn. You will find the restaurant. It's simple as that.
It's.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Awesome. It's good.
Both of us have the same thing, I think. Right?
I think so.
Yeah.
Well, you said you had no preference. So
yeah, that's true.
Kind of got you the same thing.
Brilliant. All right. So while we dig into it, thank you. I must say, food here is really good.
Yeah.
The best part about this job is you get to try food as it
100%.
Comes out.
I'm jealous. Yeah.
But you have had it here as well.
Oh, yeah.
But you didn't try it.
Exactly.
Yeah, there you go. All right, now this is where the problem is. Have you seen me with chopstick?
I have not.
I'm like a buttered baby.
Well, this, I think just this could just, we're Sri Lankans, right?
Yeah,
I think
that's
we
true.
Can just go
hand is
hands
better.
In.
The germs are always nicer.
Exactly.
So tell me, what do you do in one day? How does your day begin and how does it end? Ooh.
So usually, if I'm up for it, golf first thing in the morning
really
gets me going. Yeah, 5:45 on the tee box, I know. But it really gives me that energy for the day. And then, of course, office by 9. Usually try and, if it's a long day, 5, 6 maybe. But if I can get out early, 3 o'clock, I'll go back to the course, get some practice in, and then hit the gym. And then it's usually family time. Dinners with the family, meet up with friends. Some drinks.
You make me very like I have not done enough for the day kind of a thing. How is your brother? Are you all polar opposites? I'm just going to begin.
We are polar opposites. Yes, please go ahead. Polar opposites. But we get along so well, and the relationship we share is just amazing. And you know, I can hands down say that we probably have the best sibling relationship from anyone I've ever met.
You all don't even look alike.
We don't.
Yeah. Like, you all have to say you all are brothers.
Little secret, though, something that he doesn't like happening. Every time we've met somebody that we've never met before, they always think he's the older brother. It's yeah. Well, I don't know why, but that's just...
Poor soul. Uh-huh. Okay, so... What? How do you all? How was it when you all were growing up? Like, how was family time? How was like things to do at home?
Family time was amazing.
Food has always been a part of your life. You all even had a restaurant chain at one time.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So growing up, I mean, we spent all our time together. Mm. So we played the exact same sports in school. Did the extracurricular activities, drama, theater. So everything was the same.
Both Athomians.
Well, Athomians, correct. And we've only a year and a half gap between the two of us.
Okay, so we're pretty much like twins. You all had a bit of a similar lifetime.
Exactly. Yeah. Same likes, same dislikes.
Okay.
He's the very impatient one that, you know, really feisty, gets angry.
Is he more introvert and you are more extrovert?
In a way, yeah, he is. I've
sort of noticed that.
After a few drinks, though, he goes all the way to the extrovert side.
Let me just match it there.
Thank you so much.
That's my garlic rice.
Chicken.
Oh, that looks really nice, though.
That does look good. There's a braised pork belly.
Mine looks prettier.
But mine probably tastes better, so. How do you like that?
I had that dagger stare for a minute there. I was like, this is really good. It's just that I'm trying to see if I don't want to look a glut on screen, man. That's the only reason.
Sometimes you just shouldn't care.
I know. What am I saying? I've eaten all my shows.
Exactly.
I know. All right. So good.
It is, right? Fantastic.
Now, being a married man, did you ever expect you to be married at a young age?
Yes. I've always been a relationship kind of person.
Okay.
So was in a 5.5 year relationship starting at the age of 15.
What?
To 20. Yeah. Yeah. And then
15?
Yes. You know, the high school sweetheart thing. And then I went to the US, that ended, then I found, you know, met Tegan, so now we've been together 7 years, married 3.
Okay.
So I've always been the relationship type of
person. You're like the, you know, let's settle down soon.
Exactly. Okay. Settle down, have kids, do that whole thing.
Oh, have you all got to the second part? No, not yet.
Not yet. So 3 years, and you know, it's just been a lot of traveling up and down
between
the US.
Living life.
Correct. So we've put that on hold for a little bit just to get everything settled and...
Okay. Did you ever expect to be married to someone who is not Sri Lankan?
I did not. No, it was never planned. And you can never plan those things, right? Just let it go with the flow and then...
But you know, I'm always for mixed genes because it's always good.
100%.
We create a healthier tomorrow and we all become brown eventually.
Right. Exactly.
That's what the world has told.
Sure.
The world has been predicted to be brown in another few years' time.
Really?
Yeah. It's going to be one tone. So all these people who do unwanted amount of makeup shades have to stop.
There we go.
Yeah.
And I think racism would stop then.
Exactly.
Right? So I'm all...
And you are the start.
There we go.
Round of applause.
Yes. Good stuff.
More marriages on these lines. Now tell me about... now we spoke about your food. What are your cheat meals? Now we know it's pizza.
So yeah.
How do you counteract the cheat meal?
So my theory is that I work out and do enough activity during my week to be able to then... eat like a fat ass.
Okay, so what are the cheat days?
Both weekends.
Both.
Friday Sunday.
Night onwards or Saturday onwards?
Usually Friday night onwards.
There you go. That's what, When I used to be on a diet, Friday night I raid that fridge.
Yeah.
Like
there you go.
As if I've never seen a fridge.
Right.
Like I sit and do a thesis on it. I'm like, there you go. That's that chocolate that I've been looking at.
Plus Friday night everybody goes out, right? So you go for all these bites and the drinks start flowing and I mean that's calories in itself, right? The alcohol.
Yeah.
So it just kind of, it counts towards the cheat part of the whole.
Okay, so Monday to Friday, you living this 5:30 in the morning life is worth it.
It's absolutely worth it. And I mean, you know, you just gotta live life a little bit. And at the same time for me, it's all about everything in moderation.
Yeah.
Everything in moderation is good. Don't overdo anything. Don't, you know.
Somebody said, you know, if you live 80% good, 20% cheating is totally fine. So you do 5 days of it.
There you go. Yeah. Except in a relationship.
I didn't bring it there. I didn't bring it there just to be safe.
Yeah.
Just so that we
in
all
that
know.
100%, 100% that's 100% commitment.
He is 100% in that.
Oh, for sure.
So now, family bonds are very important to Sri Lankans. Home sweet home, how close-knit are y'all?
Very close.
Do you all at least sit for one meal together, all of you?
Every Sunday night.
Oh, so we do
church, and then the family meets for dinner, and we each get to pick a different restaurant every week.
Right, okay. So you all go out as a family.
Exactly.
Okay.
And so we try new places, all of, you know, these new places.
Okay. So you all have a spot here now?
We have actually been here.
Oh, there you go. Family has been here.
Yes, absolutely. I loved it.
There you go. Just wanted to speak about the good things about food is the fact that it sort of brings everyone together. Mm-hmm. And that's actually a reason. Like, if you ever meet up with people, you just have to eat. That's the whole point. We need to get into a break. I'm going to just try out my main. It looks really good. But the point is, by the time I get this chicken piece into this, it's just going to be impossible. I'm just going to get a fork during the break. We'll see you on the other side with something sweet right here on Dunno on Fire on Hi TV. I'm sure Ranshan will agree that we have a spectacular view. It just became to a became a romantic setting for us. Yeah, it's Dunno on Fire. Hello, you're a Thomian.
Yeah.
I'm sure you can bear this.
100%.
We're at C'est La Vie, the restaurant that's on the rooftop at Kingsbury Hotel. Make sure you make your bookings to come and enjoy a fine meal here. So Ranshan, we just have a question on set.
Mm-hmm.
What does Ranshan stand for?
So it doesn't really have a meaning per se, but how the name came about.
Somebody was running and there was a shine.
No, my dad's name is Ranjan and my mom is Shanaz. So the first two syllables were Ran, Shan, and just put it together. And
your brother just was named Shehan.
Just got Shehan. It was just like, we can't be bothered.
Search for the first name that we find. Okay, fine. Yeah, there you go.
There you go. Boom. Yeah. Lot of effort, no effort. Yeah, pretty much.
So it was the same for my sister. There was only one name kept for her.
Okay.
Tushara. That was just one name.
Right.
I had a book.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
And they named me nothing out of the book, by the way.
Totally.
Nothing. They just found something else from the list. It was like, even if I looked like a cow, they would have still named me. That's it. There was nothing else.
Nice.
Tell me about your sweet addiction.
Oh, see, so that is actually my secret to staying healthy is I don't eat sweets.
Oh, right. So you're not a sweet.
Not a sweet.
Oh, that's my weakness. I will sip through. Like, I can't eat a lot of chocolates together.
Right.
But I need it. You need that fix.
Sure.
Yeah.
So I guess my thing would be chocolate biscuit pudding.
Okay.
Like, I like just trying different flavors, different people make it different ways.
That is true.
I always prefer if the sugar content is very low.
Yeah, and it has more dark depth
the
to it,
chocolatey
right?
rather than the sugary.
I hate when they cheat me with like this icing put in it.
Oh, for
I
sure.
I'd be like, listen, it's chocolate biscuit, but not icing biscuit pudding.
Exactly.
Just to let you know what we're having, this is a hazelnut truffle brownie. And you're having
mango cheesecake.
See, he always knows what he's
fantastic.
Having.
Fantastic.
Yeah, but yours look really pretty.
It's
though.
So pretty. It's got like a flower petal thing.
Can I dig into mine?
Please,
yeah.
please.
But
go
we
ahead.
Have come to an agreement that we will share these
yes,
desserts.
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah, because mine looks really unhealthy, and yours look healthy for some odd reason.
I guess it's the chocolate that throws it away.
Yeah, but this is actually homemade ice cream. It's my favorite. It's always nice to enjoy homemade ice cream because it just makes it. More special that like somebody didn't scoop it off a dish.
Mm.
Is it so good?
Oh yeah. Mm. And the mango pieces around it really just add to the whole.
If somebody just sees you making that noise with just me here, Columbo will talk.
Oh, that's okay with me. Let them talk.
Yes, needed this.
Let them talk.
Oh, this is really good.
Fantastic.
The ice cream itself is so good. Mm. Oh wow, I'm sorry I had to like maintain a few minutes of silence there. How was Christmas celebration? How are Christmas celebrations? Are y'all like big?
Massive. So my dad
biggest turkey comes out. Are y'all a turkey person?
Yes, we are. So we do the turkey, the roast pork.
Really?
We do all the meats.
For me, turkey tastes like carpet. Like this. However much you put on it, the flavors are just bland. It's like,
sure.
I as a bird cannot be impressed with any of your spice.
Right.
Yeah.
But I guess my mother-in-law, since you know that it's an American tradition and they do it for Thanksgiving and everything, it's done right.
Right, okay.
You know, so we find somebody here that can do it as well and then get it home.
Right.
But Christmas traditions are big for us because my dad has five sisters, so All of them are here. Two are in Canada, but they fly down. And then the whole family, just 30 of us in my grandma's house. Okay. Christmas exchange with the Secret Santa as well as the gifts.
Okay. So it's always nice when it's a big family, right?
Exactly. And then we always pick one of the uncles or the cousins to dress up as Santa.
Right.
So they'll go, get ready, and then come out of nowhere. No one's expecting it. Dance, you know, play the food.
Did you ever believe in Santa Claus when you were growing up?
I did, absolutely. Okay. I still do.
Do you know, I saw like this dusty, smoky thing up in the sky. I'm sure he farted.
Sure. Yeah. Because was it sprinkles or
it
rainbows?
Was just like a spray.
Or?
I think maybe he was just shooting off.
Oh, yeah. Maybe.
I believe in Santa.
Absolutely.
It makes a lot of sense to believe.
And it's an extra gift under the tree.
There you go. Yeah. I don't know.
Because the moment you stop believing Santa,
nowadays
you
I buy my own because nobody's giving it to me. I sort of broke this dessert.
That's okay. You gotta, you know, make it happen.
It's really good though.
But you gotta try this.
I'll come there.
Mm-hmm.
It's really good. See, this is the show why I can't be thin.
Right.
I've always wondered why, and this is the show because I've somehow searched for shows which have food in it.
I don't blame you.
Even if they hate me, they'll watch it for the show.
Yeah.
For the food. They're like, food. I hate that boy, but he's eating some good things. Just for the fun of it.
That's so true.
How have you settled into this whole Colombo zone? Because your work requires you to associate closely. And you have been a face on high for some time now.
I guess.
Yeah. Certain people really like having you on screen. So I just wanted to see how is it for you to sort of... Society is a very interconnected place. And
sure. Absolutely.
Colombo can be a bit of a...
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Definitely. I think my secret would be because I'm tied to the US in some ways because of my wife. That traveling back and forth, it gives me that reset.
You are like the Priyanka Chopra of Sri Lanka.
I guess, let's go with that. Yeah. But so just to be able to go away and spend some time away and just reset and then come back, it just gives you a different perspective and people can't don't put you into most of the conversations, which helps in a way.
Yeah.
Not that it in any negative way.
But it's always nice to stay away from the...
Exactly.
Dirt.
For sure, for sure.
And also always be a part of the good things.
Exactly, exactly.
All right, it's nearly time that we close the show. Thanks for joining me on my little date here. But the food was amazing.
It was.
And it's always good to connect with someone who loves food.
Yes, so thank you for having me. It's been a pleasure.
It's a pleasure. And have yourself a great 2019.
Thank you,
and
likewise.
May you continue living the very organized, fancy, scheduled life that you have, which is amazing. Give my love to your wife.
I will,
and
thank
we
you.
Hope to see you as a three and not as a two.
Yes, hopefully
that's
soon.
Your next step in life.
That's right.
We need to wrap things up. So a big shout out goes out to our friends who have joined us on this show. That's of course LICC Jeans. Thank you so very much for joining us on the show. And at the same time, a big shout out goes out to the Kingsbury Hotel, C'est La Vie, for opening their doors for us to dine here, to give you this experience as much as we enjoyed it as well. So next time, if you're planning a date with your special someone, you know the spot. It's red, it's romantic, it's phenomenal. You have a little bit of a loungy spot there, then you have the restaurant here. You have everything under one roof. And if you're feeling a bit too tipsy to walk, have a lift. That'll take you all the way down. We need to wrap things up. Thank you so very much. It's
Thank
a wrap.
You.
We will see you with another brilliant episode of Dunno on Fire. Take care.